Hey guys, Kool-Aid here, and today we're going to do our Light Assault Certifications Guide. Before we get started, I do want to talk about the weapons just a little bit, because in this video you're only going to see me using shotguns. Now the reason for that is not because the other two options aren't viable. In fact, the other two options, submachine guns and carbines, are probably a lot more versatile, unless you are using slugs, of course, then you're going to get some range with shotguns. But I'm using shotguns only because they fit my playstyle as a light assault to a T. I think light assaults have really good skills to allow them to get into close quarters, so that's why I like using shotguns. But I'm only mentioning this because I want you all to know that there's absolutely nothing wrong with using submachine guns or carbines. If you prefer those on your light assault, that is perfectly fine. Alright, so let's talk about certifications, and we are going to start with the suit slot like usual. There are a lot of good options here that you can go. I would probably recommend flak or nanoweave. Now the reason that I might recommend nanoweave over flak is if you are using shotguns like me. I am currently running nanoweave, and the reason I say that is because a lot of the times with using shotguns, you're going to have to absorb an extra bullet or two to close the gap and get in shotgun range. Now I think flak is probably the most beneficial overall, and another reason why I like flak a little bit more on the light assault is when you are C4ing stuff, you might not have time to get out of range of your own C4 before you have to blow it, and that flak will let you absorb a little bit more of that damage. So either way, I think either one of those I think is good. I would probably go, even though I am using nanoweave, I would probably actually recommend flak, and it's something I'm probably going to pick up both of them pretty soon here actually, but I don't think you can really go wrong with either. Advanced shield capacitor is another option that, you know, I don't typically hear many people using this, and I kind of can tell why, but it is incredibly cheap. It's only going to cost 341 certs to completely max out. The reason I'm actually intrigued by this is because a lot of the time with my playstyle is, you know, as impatient as I am, and how I'm very often in close quarters and I don't have time to always wait for a shield recharge, I'm actually thinking about testing this out within the next week or two. I will definitely let you guys know how it goes for me. I'm not going to recommend it at this point, and from what most people said, it's really not worth using. I have never had it maxed out. I will tell you that it will lower your shield recharge time from 10 seconds down to 7.5. If it was down to maybe 5 seconds, I would definitely use this often, but I'm not sure how big the 2.5 second difference is really going to be. You know, the other options in this category are the adrenaline pump. I would not use this. It's really cheap, but it's only going to be about a 10% speed increase, and it's going to be hardly noticeable. It's not really going to save you in very many situations. The grenade bandolier, I can't really recommend this on this class. Now, I would love to have 3 grenades, but with going through C4 the way I do, I can't really keep up resources if I'm going to be spamming out 3 grenades all the time as well. If you don't have any problems with resources, that might be a decent option for you. And then the ammo belt is actually also a really good option, and I know a lot of people like to run that on their light assault, especially if you're using these semi-auto or fully auto shotguns. You're going to burn through ammo incredibly fast on the light assault, but I like to play as if winning the first battle is the most important, so that's why I am currently using Nanoweaver Flak, and I would suggest probably picking up the first 3 tiers of that, whichever way you go, which is going to cost you a total of 61 certs. After that, we're going to go down and grab the second and third tier of our jump jets. This is going to cost 60 more certification points, and there was a bug with these before that ranking them up did nothing. That since has been fixed, and as I'm going to show you, rank 6 of jump jets will get you a lot higher, and it will recharge faster. Now, if you just look at the recharge meters, it looks like they are recharging at similar speeds, but what you have to remember is that rank 6, the meter is the same size, but it is actually more fuel. So if they are recharging at the same speeds according to the meter, it's actually recharging a lot faster with rank 6 because you are recharging more fuel, if that makes sense. Now, as far as drifter jets go, if you don't know anything about these, they have no vertical thrust. They're basically for kind of gliding, you could say. They will last a lot longer than the normal jump jets, but you cannot go up at all. So you kind of have to start at a high point to get the best use out of these. Now, these can be very good for dropping C4 on tanks, stuff like that. But from all the footage I have seen of drifter jets, and I have only tried them a little bit with the first tier, from all the footage I have seen, I can do pretty much most of that stuff with the normal jump jets, as well as a lot more. You know, I can get behind, go over walls, get up to platforms, get on top of mountains, all that stuff which you cannot do with the drifter jets. However, if you play light assault a lot, if that's your main class, you might want to pick these up later, you know, after you've gotten some of the other stuff, and just have one loadout dedicated to them, because in the right situation, they are very, very fun and very cool. So maybe after you've gotten everything else, go back and pick these up. So after the 60 points in your jump jets, then we're going to start saving up for both the first and second tier of C4. I know this is really expensive. The first tier is going to cost 200 certs. The second tier is going to cost 500 certs. But I guarantee you, there's nothing more important on your light assault than getting C4. One brick of C4 will kill maxes and infantry. It will not kill lightnings, any main battle tanks, or sunders. Now, two bricks will kill a lightning, two bricks will kill a main battle tank, and two bricks will set a sunder on fire. It will not kill it. One thing you can do, however, is if you have the S version of a carbine, you can equip the grenade launcher on there. Two bricks will start a sunder on fire. The grenade launcher will finish it off. I have a loadout specifically for this when I can't take out a sunder that is using mine guard on my engineer. So,
Right now.
having said all that, I know it's expensive, but it is well worth it. I think C4 is really what
That was a
defines
max
the light
SMG
assault
because of
class.
that
As much
gauge.
fun as I have using the jump jets, it wouldn't be nearly as fun if I could not rain C4 down from the sky. So that is what we are going to save for next. Now, after grabbing our two bricks of C4, then we're going to go back to our jump jets, pick up the
Hold on,
fourth
can
and fifth tier. The fourth tier is going to cost 100
Yeah, it's the
certs.
stuff on the
The
tower.
fifth tier is going to
Yeah.
cost 150 certs. But that will do, you know, a lot
Yeah,
better
too
at
much
letting us
gauge.
get those C4 on those targets, letting us keep more time in the sky. After that, we're going to go up and pick up the fourth tier of flak or nanowave, whichever you choose. That is going to cost 150 certification points. So after that, all we have left with is the final tier of flak or nano, which is 1,000 certs, or the final tier of our jump jets, which is 500 certs. So now is the time to actually check out the specialty grenades if you want to go with one of them, if one of them sounds appealing to you. Now, I have not purchased the smoke grenades. I have seen them many times in game, and they are very effective at allowing you to close the gap to your enemy, allowing your team to push ahead with causing, you know, a lot of disorientation. One thing to note about the smoke grenades is that night vision will see right through them. So, if you are running smoke grenades, pair it up with night vision, and you can really just, you know, have a huge advantage over your enemy while the smoke is out. Now, I do have flashbangs, and I have been using them pretty much the entire time I've been playing Light Assault the last few days, and I really like these. Just remember that they have one of the largest blast radiuses of any of the grenades. They probably do have the largest. It is very, very disorienting. The closer you are to the blast, the worse it is going to be. But even if you are on the outskirts, it can still be very, very bright. So the key to throwing these grenades is that they will have a detonation sound. So you want to throw these into maybe a crowded room, and you want to wait, unless you are very far away, you want to wait until you hear that detonation sound, then close in for your kills. And you can usually tell when people are affected by these because they are completely blind and they will act very erratically. So I do like using these grenades. I think these are a good purchase. And if you want to go with these, now is a great time to buy them before you actually focus on picking up the very expensive tiers of jump jet and nano or flak. So, anyways, that's pretty much all I have. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that thumbs up and that subscribe button if you have not already. And as always, guys, thanks for watching. I'll talk to y'all later.